Welcome to your journey into the exciting world of predictive analytics with Pecan. Today, we're going to walk through the simple yet powerful steps of creating your first machine learning model. As an extra thrill, everything you'll see in this video is generated live, showcasing the real-time capabilities of Pecan. So whether you're a pro or beginner, this guide is designed to demystify the process and show you how to turn your data, yes, even if it's messy, into actionable predictions. Let's dive in. So once you log into Pecan, the first thing you're going to see is our predictive chat, and it will guide you through the process of precising your predictive question. It asks you, what would you like to predict? So let's say that I have a website or an online store, and I want to know who is not going to make another purchase. So Pecan will, or the chat will now guide us through a series of four questions to really define our predictive question in a very specific way that is crucial for a good model. So the first question, can you confirm that the subject of the prediction is your customers? Yes, yes it is. The second question is going to be about the activity that I want them to predict, what they're going to do. So it asks if I want to predict who is not going to make another purchase. So yes, that's correct. The third question is going to be about how far into the future I would like to predict this. So let's say that I want to know 1 month ahead before of them not making another purchase. And the last question is when I want to know it. So what should trigger this 1 month ahead? Should it be every week? I would like to know what's going to happen in the following month. Or in my case, I would like to know it 1 month after making a purchase. Meaning they make a purchase, I wait 1 month. If they didn't do anything else, I want to know if in the upcoming month they will make another purchase. If not, I can send them a coupon, special offer, stuff like that. Okay, so the final predictive question is predict 1 month after a customer makes a purchase, whether they will not make another purchase in the following month. That is precise, that is correct. We can refine it further to say stuff like only purchase from a specific category or only above a certain amount, but for me, it looks good, so I want to continue with my build. Okay, so now Pecan asks me if I want to generate model using some mock data, so I can just play around with the platform, or if I want to upload my own data, and of course I want to use my own data. So because I am working with Pecan for the first time, it doesn't have any of my data, so it asks me to upload a file. So I'm going to upload my transactions table as it is. I'm just uploading it. Now Pecan analyzes the table. It will actually show us the schema by listing the column names, and it will also figure out on its own the type of each column. Let's give it a second to process. Okay, so we can see all the columns that I have for each transaction and the type. Some are dates, some are integers, some are numbers, some are strings. Looks good. Yeah, I want to use this table. So Pecan will have another look at the table and it will try and figure out which columns it can use for the process. So we need to identify the customers that we want to predict for. We need two key columns. We need the date and I want the customer ID. So we identified the two columns. Perfect, I can confirm. The next thing that Pecan is going to ask me is about using the date column as the column from which it can calculate the prediction time. So I said that I want to know it 1 month after they're making a purchase, and this is exactly what Pecan understands it can use this column for, so I can confirm. At any point, if you don't understand what the chat is asking you, you can ask it back and it will explain itself even better. Okay, we're done with the process and now we get a summary. So we got a predictive question, which looks good. We got the schema that it's going to use for the predicted activity, and we've got what it's going to use for the triggering event. Perfect. So let's click Generate Notebook. So Pecan is now generating a predictive notebook, which is an SQL notebook in a very familiar interface that you already know. And it's actually building the notebook tailor-made for your business use case using your own data that you've uploaded. And the purpose of this notebook is to take your existing table and organize it into a machine learning ready table. And it does that automatically, as you'll see in a second. in this table, the idea is that each line, each row, tells a story of a customer from the date they made the purchase and everything we know about them. Okay, welcome to the notebook. And as you can see, as I mentioned, this is a very straightforward SQL notebook. We have some context cells and we have some query cells. These cells explain everything that is going on. So you get a full explanation of the logic of what's going on. The idea is to create two tables. The first one is called the core set, and this is a list of past samples of customers who did not make another purchase. The second table that we can or should build is the attribute table. This table contains all the information that we know about these customers, all the information that Pecan will be able to use to create a model and base its predictions upon. So the first thing we see is, let's click run all just so we can see all the tables that we built. So the first table is finding the relevant customers for our core set. And you can see that it creates, using my data, using my file that I just uploaded, a list of the customer IDs, the date of their transactions, and the sampling date, because we said that we want to predict 1 month after they make a purchase. So we can see that this customer made a purchase on this date, and we sample them on this date. And we do this for all the customers. And this table is called sample customers. Scrolling down, we have the label, our positive and negative examples. And you can see that this table is going to create a customer ID, their sample date that we take from the previous sale, and the new count called, did the customer make a transaction within 1 month? Now, this code can be hard to understand. You know, it's pretty straightforward day-to-day SQL, but it's complex and you didn't write it. So if you need any assistance with this, you can click explain, and Pecan will actually look at the code and explain everything that is going on in the code. So you can really understand what's going on and what's the logic here. You can see the case here that actually determines if it's going to say yes or no on this column. And Pecan will explain everything right here on the side. Okay, so this is our core set. This is the table of the samples that we are going to train a model on. Now we need to add additional useful data to train the model. And this is what we call attributes. And you can add as many of them as you want. But right now we only have the CSV file. So actually Pecan took that file with all the columns that we have in it and made an attribute out of it. Pecan is actually going to use all these columns to train the model and base its predictions upon. And you can see a preview of everything that we have in this file. And it actually joins this file with our core set right up here. So we get a table that has, who are we talking about? When are we talking about them? What was the final result? Did they make a purchase after 1 month? And all we know about them so far. And this big file that we're going, big table that we're going to create is going to be used to train the model. So after this, that's it. We're ready to train the model. We can actually click train model and again, click train model. And what's going on now is that Pecan is actually running some validations on our data to ensure that it's good enough and that everything is perfect and it's ready to train the model. If something is off, Pecan will let you know and you will be able to fix it. But in our case, everything seems good. So we can go to the model tab. And that's it. In about 20 to 30 minutes, you will get a notification via email that your model is ready and you can log back in or come back and refresh the page and watch the dashboard. And if you want to learn more about the dashboard, you're welcome to watch our next video. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful rest of your day.